Hello everyone and welcome back to another video here at Tablemon. Thanks so much for tuning in. A lot of people have been requesting more Reggie. I guess I'm known quite a bit because of Worlds and people want to see me play Reggie. So here we are. Yeah, a few modifications to the Worlds list. No more Thornton shenanigans. I've given it a try and I've basically given up on it. I don't think, like, you can't pull it off consistently. Your main concern is not that drawing with this deck and being able to attack as quickly as you can, which the gift energies help you, the Pokestops help you, the heavy ball helps unlock Pokemon out of the prize cards. But Thornton is such a late game card, and you need the Evil Doll, and it's not worth it. You know, you're more likely to attack if you get a turn two attack or a turn one attack than if you actually end up using Thornton at some point. So that's why we're sticking with the basics. 2-2-2-2-2 of each REGIGIGAS, of course, with Ancient Wisdom ability, allowing us to attach up to 3 energy cards, up to the being the key that I completely forgot about at Worlds, up to being the key in order to be able to attach energies once you have all the Regis in play and the energies in the discard pile. And our main attackers will be Regieleki, like Staraspark, doing 120 and 40 to the bench, and also Regidrago doing 160 for a very, which is a very solid amount right now, and Dragon's Ward also allowing you to draw extra cards once Regidrago is in the active spot. Regirock has merit, doing 140, 2-hit killing stuff, and being fighting type against potential Arceus or Hisuian Zorax. We also have Registeel, which isn't great. The Pokemon that it hits for weakness such as Kyurem and Ice Rider really sucks against, but it can be decent against Mew by doing Heavy Slam and not getting any of the damage reduced because they don't have Retreat Cost. And then we have Regice with the Blizzard Bind attack. I feel like this attack is potentially really good, but there's so few spots that you end up actually using it. And if you're actually using that attack, then it's not that great. And you're probably a little bit behind because it's not as offensive as the other attack. So I don't know. I definitely feel like I try to keep this attack a lot in mind and find spots for it, but usually rarely ever works out. So, but still a nice defense against V Pokemon that can't attack during your next turn, at least force a switch or force resources out of your opponent. And then we have the good old Research Marnie Cynthia, along with 2 Buzz Disorders to chase down stuff. Now I am not playing 3 Path to a Peak, along with 2 Pokestop instead of the 4 Pokestop. You could play 3 Pokestop, 2 Path to a Peak if you really wanted to go aggressive on the draw. But 3 Path to a Peak really helps out with Empoleon decks, especially those that are playing 2 now. Because otherwise they really slow you down quite a bit. So those are important. And then of course our 4 beloved choice builds, our 4 beloved scoop up nets to switch around, 4 ordinary rod for recovery, and then the new addition, the gift energies, which allow you to draw until you have 7 cards when a Pokemon is knocked out, holding this energy, which should happen often enough to where it helps you getting out of dead draws and helps you finding the resources you need when you need them. Let's jump in the ladder after this quick message from our sponsors and see how we can do with Reggie. If you're planning on buying any cards from TCG Player, make sure you use our affiliate link right here in the description of our video to help support the channel. It's the best way to do it and it's free. Looking for PTGO codes? Photon Store has all the latest sets and promos instantly delivered to your email. You can use Tablemon code when checking out for 5% off. Card Market is Europe's largest online marketplace for Pokemon cards. Whether you're looking for sealed product or singles, vintage or the latest sets, just follow the link in the description to find what you need. This video is sponsored by the Pokemon TCG deck building website, PokemonCard.io. Alright, not off to the best start with this hand, like we can't do much, but getting the 2 energies immediately into the discard pile, like the 2 auroras, is actually pretty significant. To the point where I could just attach the aurora, but I would have to discard. Well, I mean, that would keep the ultra ball, I guess. Do I realistically expect to attack with Registeel next turn? I mean, maybe. It could also allow the Regigate. So this guarantees that I now have 2 energies down. It means I didn't get to use the Ultra Ball though, because I don't want to discard the Ordinary Rod, and I definitely can't discard the Marnie. The boss is definitely the expendable card here. Interesting to see Radiant Blastoise. So it'll be interesting to see what we are up against. I understand the like the potential of extra damage with Pump Shot by discarding water energies, but I don't think that's ever going to be better than Greninja, and I don't think that's ever going to be better than Charizard in Lost Box decks, and I certainly don't think this is better than Radiant Gardevoir in this sort of deck. Oh, we see Greedent though as well. Okay. So interesting. And by interesting, I mean odd, honestly. Okay. So another Raw Battle VIP pass. What the heck? So the sequencing here is really weird because my opponent has not drawn any cards. But yeah, I mean, that's a solid setup, right? It's absolutely a solid setup. But with no Dunsparce, this should be a fairly straightforward matchup, especially with two Aurora energies already having been discarded. Like, that's pretty, pretty big right here. Definitely really important. All right, so we're gonna see the Trinity Charge onto itself. Okay, so, all right. Okay, with this, I'm gonna check my prize cards. I feel like I should just research here. No, I feel like I win this game by stabilizing. So I'm not going to research. I'm going to Marnie to conserve the Ordinary Rod because I also don't know how many Regis are prized, if I prized any, and or what else is up, right? So I'm going to grab a Lecky, even though I obviously want to attack with Regirock at some point. I don't need to do it this turn, it's still fine. But the most important thing being that I really want to give myself the option to draw extra cards off of the speed energy if I draw that. Yeah, so that's why I'm choosing that. And then I did price two Ordinary Rods. Okay, I did not price any Regis, which is good. I did price two Ordinary Rods, so I'm very, very happy with my decision to be conservative. Yeah. Which could have really backfired. Okay, so I do find a gift energy, which is really, really fantastic, along with a path to a peak. Play the gift energy as a stadium. I'll attach the gift energy to the active, make it so that if the Registeel does go down, I am able to... it seems like I will want to attack with... Well, no, if Registeel goes down. Yeah, so I'll get the Regirock, threaten that. If Registeel gets knocked out, I get the extra energies for the gift energy. If it doesn't, then that's fine. The stadium gets countered immediately. And I mean, I'm a little worried, I guess, about Radiant Blastoise. Not super worried. This is not a serious deck, though. Like, you should not expect to see that regionals. Toy Catcher, Cleansing Gloves. The Mew, the Echoing Horn. It's more like a meme deck, yeah? Greedent VMAX is not a very serious card, in my opinion. It's a nice gimmick. I remember when it was shown, people were saying, oh no, ADP is back. Ah, they didn't learn from their mistakes. They didn't blah, blah. People are just so exaggerated. Like, they really like to exaggerate things. All right, so there's a research. That means, as long as there's no Pokemon Catcher or something like that, I will be getting extra cards off of the gift energy, which is fantastic. What's really impressive is that my opponent's down to 15 cards already in their deck, and they're down all for research too. Like I said, I'm not worried about this at all because no Dunsparce. And the best part is losing Registeel is the best Regi to lose, because it's the least useful. Okay, the fact that my opponent actually kept those two cards in their hand is even further reassurance that I am 100% safe at this point in time. All right, so this is perfect. I get to pull trouble away, scoop up net, and gift energy for one of the missing Regis, which is Regice, and I get to attach a capture energy to the Regieleki for a potential retreat to establish the steal that just got KO'd, and then I get to take a knockout, a perfect knockout with Regirock on this and with a gift energy attached. So if they play around the gift energy with a boss, that means I get to keep the Regirock powered up and I don't need another Regi. And if they knock out the Regi, then that's even better. I'm gonna go ahead and do this now. I want to prevent like any weird shenanigans with the Radiant Blastoise, and I'll just go ahead and take the KO. I could Marnie, honestly. My hand doesn't really allow for a good Regi replacement next turn, but the Choice Belt could be important against a potential Greed End, and the boss would allow me to potentially do stuff. So you know what? I'm just going to keep this hand. The one issue with the Gift Energy is if you're taking a knockout, then your hand, especially against a 2-prizer, your hand will be a little bit fuller, right? So you don't get as big of an advantage, but that's okay. Really not super concerned about this right now. I got a turn to attack, also a turn to one hit KO on that Arceus. I've been choosing to refocus on the Regidrago, which is interesting, instead of the Aleki. And we see a Body Slam. Okay. So I will not be getting a KO on the Greedent, but I can't just get a KO on the Crobat by retreating. So this is just even better. I'll go ahead and retreat, promote on the Regidrago, go boss on the Crobat, attach the Choice Belt, attach the energies yet again. And then I guess this is where I just burn this. Two ordinary rods priced, still just completely fine. I'll do this, I'll do the Dragon's Horde. Things are just looking really, really good. I would be very surprised if I somehow managed to lose this game. This gives me a guaranteed retreat as well, no matter what, into the right Pokemon. So that's it, right? There's no humanly possible way my opponent can get out of this. And I just unlocked the two ordinary rods. So now I have three in my hand. So in the end, it wouldn't have mattered if I discard the ordinary rod, just because of how dominating this is. And my opponent could turn a profit, right? Knocking out this Regirock right here, which generally, well, I guess it would matter. I guess it will matter because now I need a Choice Belt, right? Now I do need a Choice Belt. In order to get this KO. Oh, actually, I do. I do need a Choice Belt. The Marnie potentially helps out here. I don't get the bonus off the Gift Energy. But four cards is still pretty decent. There's a Cynthia and there's a Scoop Up Net. So all I need is a Choice Belt now. So we'll see if we can hit that Choice Belt. I'm down all my boss's orders, so I can't actually win by knocking out the Arceus. If they had Dunsparce, this would actually have been really bad. Nice. Turn a profit for 90. So they can potentially win if they attack my Regidrago next turn. All I need is a Choice Belt, and then I can either knock out with a Gigas or Drago. I mean, or Regirock, sorry. All right, so I'm gonna quick ball away the research, and I'm gonna grab Regice, and I'm gonna quick ball away. Actually, I'm gonna quick ball away Aleki. Yeah, I'm gonna quick ball away Aleki, and then I'll grab the rock. I do have two Choice Belts, and I do have two Pokestops for further draw. So I think now is time to just do this. Right. And Cynthia for 8. There's a choice build, second card I drew. And I do have enough to power up the Regigigas, right? Yes. So I can take the KO in style. I'm not making any mistakes. Maybe I'll just do it with a weakness. I will simply do it with the weakness right here. The two Auroras and choice build for game. Pretty easy, pretty simple, straightforward. Those two Aurora energies in the beginning were super huge and super, super impactful. So, on to our next match. All right, new match. Double Sobble plus Bucket probably means Palkia. If it weren't for the Bucket, it could still mean Arceus Intel, I guess. But this should mean Palkia. And no Palkia, it seems, on turn one, which is fantastic for me. Once again, with the... Oof. Okay, that is an unfortunate top deck. So here's to hoping the other two ordinary rods are, in fact, not prized. Okay, I did not attach there because of the chance of having a capture energy. I do find Gigas. I do believe my Regieyes is safe next turn, right? So I don't need to attach the gift energy at this point in time. And I will go ahead and Regigate for the Regieleki, which I also prized. Priced a Regieleki and a Heavy Ball, and I'm down to Ordinary Rod. So that's going to be a really tricky game to pull off. All right. There's Iridum. So the advantage that my opponent got from going first is now gone. And assuming I don't pick another ordinary rod, it's gonna be very tight, but we should be in a decent spot. Losing the Bossless Orders will be less than ideal, but getting a KO off the Regieyes will be pretty big. I do have the Aurora available already. And here, my opponent, you tried to play into a Ghost KO on the Aleki, right? There's no combination of cards that I could draw here that would allow me to attack with Aleki this turn onto the Palkia. So what does the drizzle get here? Another bucket, okay. So really thinning a lot. Imagine if I Marnied here, that'd be pretty sweet. Imagine if I had more Regis. I guess there is. No, there isn't. There really isn't. If I top deck a Regi, and then I Pokestop into two Quick Balls and a Scoop Up Net, then and only then I would be able to knock out the Palkia. I don't think that's something I'm going to try. Just going to go ahead and attach the choice build, play the Pokestop, and research. Oh, that's actually potentially good. But once again, if I attach that, I am not attaching a capture energy. But I'll give it a try. Well, there's the capture, the aforementioned capture energy. I'll just go ahead and research. But yeah, that's one less Regi I'll be able to find now. Okay, I need a Quick Ball No. Not only did I not get a quick ball, I also discarded both Registeels. Oh my god. This is quite possibly the worst case scenario I could have gotten. What the heck was that Pokestop? That probably just sealed my fate. The speed energy, the temptation of the speed energy. If I don't play the speed energy, I draw the capture, and then I just find the Regirock and the Regidrago, and I get an attack. So I, the temptation of the speed energy, and the temptation of being able to boss that turn. I should have thought it through more. I should have just researched, honestly, to allow myself the option of capture energy. The fact that I haven't found a single Quick Ball or Ultra Ball is also pretty astounding, though. And especially off of that Pokestop, and it's honestly very unlucky that that just happened. And yep, there it is. Unreal. Unfreaking real what just happened. Especially because I have a Regieleki priced too. So this is just like worst case scenario after worst case scenario after worst case scenario too. And all because I wouldn't say I was greedy, but all right, yeah, I was gonna say they don't establish another Palkia. That's the definition of greedy. Okay, this turn I can freely. Oh wow, really? Oh yeah, okay, you get that back, and then they need to Quick Ball for another Palkia, right? This turn I can start with the Pokestop. Right? It would suck if I get a choice belt. That really be ideal if I got an Ordinary Rod. If I don't hit Ordinary Rod this turn, I'm out of the game. If I don't get a return KO on this Palkia, the game's over. Absolutely 100% over. That Pokestop was just out of this world. Brutal. Okay. Oh yeah, I was gonna say, like, if you don't even bench the mana fee, then this is even better. This is rough. I should be one price ahead. Instead, now I'm one price behind, and I lost my Leku with my choice belt, and I lost both Registeels, and there's just a lot going on. At least I have the retreat after research, though, which is good. Okay. Alright, I shouldn't start. Well, I kind of want to play down the path to the peak as well. Now it's useless. Now the Ultra Ball is actually useless. I really do kind of want to play the path to the peak. How do I do this? The most optimal way. Part of me says Pokestop first. And then replace. I don't think I can risk that though. This really sucks. Like, it generally really sucks. I'm just gonna double check to see I didn't see wrong, but yeah. This is absolutely brutal. All right. Well, here goes nothing. Oh my gosh, jeez, barely got there, just barely. Oh my, all right, goodbye Pokestop. Just barely. And then I do have a gift energy in the discard already, right? Yes. So I can keep the speed just in case. All right. So we do things correctly. Retreat. Let's power up with a gift. Because we fully expect my opponent to take a knockout here. And it's two extra cards. right? I will be taking two here. Fine. Two extra cards, always welcome. So this is early enough to the point where as long as I can one-shot that upcoming Palkia, I should be fine. So that last choice build just became one of, if not the most important card in my deck. And I will not be looking at a lot of cards this turn. I also play into the Roxanne. Very intense game. Very like, ugh, what is happening? All right. I mean, I do have the Regieye's backup plan as well, right? Incense and Echoing Fern. Interesting combination. Is there ever a universe where my opponent goes Collapse Stadium, Bunkaboo, Echoing Fern? Alright, that Big Charm doesn't... Oh, it does change things. Oh. Okay, so the Big Charm just changed the fact that so I can never one-shot this Palkia now. So the Big Charm is essentially a tool jammer at this point, which is fine. I can two-shot the Palkia. That is completely okay. And still be ahead. To see a Raihan. Okay, so the big issue here is finding... getting another Aleki into play. If I end up using Ordinary Rod to pull it off, that's gonna be less than ideal. I'll get to draw two cards, then my top deck. That's three. Then I get to Marnie, I get to look at the next eight cards, and then I get to use Pokestop. So unless the heavy ball is in the bottom three cards, should be fine. All right, so definitely need to promote Draco here to knock out the Inteleon. If I Pokestop here, what do I risk losing? Supporters. I think I always Barney first here. All right, please don't be in the bottom three cards. Heavy ball, pretty please. Here we go. All right, well, I mean, I can get the Regieleki back, but it would be great if I don't have to do that. There it is. Okay, so I did lose a Regirock in the process, however. I missed the Regidrago. Okay, I really need to hit this Regidrago. Okay, I have a high chance of... if I don't hit the Regidrago, that's actually okay, right? That is actually a-okay. Because of the fact that it's either I have a 75% chance at hitting that because I have two heavy balls in my prize cards and the Regidrago. So if I hit either of the heavy balls or the Regidrago, that's fine. And there's the Regidrago. Okay. So I guess now the question is, does my opponent go after Regieleki? And if they don't, maybe this is a turn I attack with Regieye to make it even more awkward for my opponent to try to be able to attack. They are down only two cross switchers. Am I down both my boss's orders? I think I am. Yeah, I am. Okay, so this choice build I need to pay for the last Palkia. They go down to three. I attack them. They knock me out. They go down to two. Then I KO them, I'm at one, they attack me, they go down to one, and then choice belted Regieleki closes out the game. Right? So that's all I need to do. Generally all I need to do. They don't need to bench a Palkia now because this one is 100% safe from getting one shot. I'm not playing the triple. Oh boy. Okay, I have one stadium left exactly. Oh my gosh. And we know it's not priced. Okay. Gosh, this is just such an awkward. Okay, that's very fortunate, I guess. Go ahead and play this. Let's go ahead and play this. And let's just, I'm not gonna play anything else. I'm just gonna do this. Gosh, they really have all the stops here against Reggie. All right. Now they can't attack this turn. Right? If I were one turn behind, I would be losing this game. So you can see how, like, Thornton, like, you can barely even play boss. Right? You can barely even play boss. Okay. The path to a peak being in play is potentially pretty huge in terms of them having a backup Palkia. 180 HP means I am forced to use a Lackey. Okay, I will be getting Roxanne, but that's completely fine. Unless they're playing a second copy of Temple of Sinnoh. If they are, then that's just insane. If they don't take a knockout here, though, then that's just game over. Because I do have my Ordinary Rod left. So if they don't attack this turn, it's absolutely game over. And now they need to draw double Cross Switcher plus an Energy or a Scoop of Net raw off of that Roxanne. And I have my beautiful Gift Energy protecting me and gifting me 5 extra cards right here. Super, super intense Palkia matchup right here. Super, super intense. All right, they decide to retreat. Okay, that is completely, completely fine by me. So I knock out this Palkia, and then what I need is a replacement. A Regieleki, correct? So I should try to get ready for that. So, assuming I'm not getting Roxanne again, I should absolutely take this KO. Well, my hand isn't great though. No, I really should. Yeah, I really should. And I'll also be doing this. Failing the search, I have my Rod, my Scoop of Net, and my Choice Belt and Supporters. So it's basically this. If my opponent doesn't knock me out, then I just power up again, attack, and win. If my opponent does knock me out, I have so few cards left in my deck that I can confidently, I can confidently say that I will draw everything I need, no problem. And I'm not at risk of getting decked out. Pretty good. Very tough matchup though. The Big Charm is similar to the Tool Jammer. It provides extra protection against Giratina V-Star that you wouldn't get off the Tool Jammer. So definitely expect that card to be a little more popular, which could mean there's merit to the super effective classes over the fourth choice build. However, you saw in the Arceus match that you don't get bonus damage against Crobat with Regidrago or something like that, right? So the bonus 30 across the board is great. It's great against VMAXes as well for Regigigas, so questionable. Yeah, but thanks so much for tuning in. Hope you enjoyed Regis. Really love this deck, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.